Ladies and gentlemen, fasten your seatbelts and prepare your taste buds as we embark on a relentless journey through the kingdom of brews. Welcome to the realm of intoxicating flavors and head-banging beer reviews.
Slayer! What's up, everybody? It's the Ginger Yeti. I'm back at home. My tour's over. I figured it's time for a beer. It's a beautiful evening here in Cleveland, Ohio, and the beer I have for you today is Rain and Blood. This beer is from Dark Horse Brewing out of Marshall, Michigan. And obviously, like, I'll show some better pictures of this can, but obviously this is a tribute to Slayer. Now, for those of you who don't know, Slayer is a pretty famous thrash metal band. They've been around forever. And they have an album called Rain in Blood, and it's spelled R-E-I-G-N. Unlike this can, which is R-A-I-N. Now, Rain in Blood was the third studio album from Slayer. It came out in 1986. And two of the most prominent songs off that album were Angel of Death and Raining Blood. So again, not only is this playing off of the album name, it's also playing off of one of their very famous songs, Raining Blood. Now, there's a blurb on the can here. Our tribute to the late Jeff Hanneman. Those of you who don't know, Jeff Hanneman was one of the founding guitar players, songwriters, and unfortunately he died back in May of 2013. So our tribute to the late Jeff Hanneman and the greatest band of all time, Slayer! This pale ale is brewed with fresh blood oranges and blood orange juice that is hand-squeezed at the brewery. It says here 5% alcohol, 11.7 IBUs, pairs well with nachos, black beer chili, and delicious heavy metal. So, I'm going to guess this is going to be kind of an orangish color. And today, since I'm at home, I'm going to use a real glass. And it's not even just a regular glass, it's a beer glass. That's a shocker for a lot of people out there. So, as we get into this, Untappd says this gets a 3.51. Beer Advocate says it's a 80 good with a 3.53 average. Wow, that might be the worst pour I have ever done. Holy crap. That might take a while to go down. Good thing this is a large glass. So the bottom here, if you can see that color, that's a nice orangish color. I expected that to be kind of orangey, and that's a nice orange color. Head, about 3 miles of it. I mean, that is a terrible, terrible pour, but it is actually dissipating quite quickly, so that's kind of good. Otherwise, we'd be sitting here all night talking about Slayer while we wait for this head to die down. See if I can get the rest of this can in the glass. I don't remember where I got this beer. It was sitting in the fridge. It was about $2.30. I can't remember if I picked this up or if a beer day with TK picked this up, or if we bought a couple of them or what. But at any rate, it's in my fridge, so I'm doing a video. Luckily, that head is dissipating real quickly. It's just turning into, like, nothing. I mean, it's a big, frothy, orangish head, and it is big, huge bubbles turning into nothing real quickly. I don't know if you can see it. There's a whole lot of carbonation in that beer. There's just a ton of carbonation there. As far as the smell, I'm not getting a whole lot out of it. Maybe a very slight hint of orange and just kind of a generic beer smell. Very slight hint of orange. Kind of disappointed in that. I expected a beer like this named after or in honor of a crushingly amazing metal band would just have a big in-your-face smell and a big in-your-face taste. So hopefully the taste is better than the smell. I mean, there is some orange there, but it's pretty weak. Let's get into it. you do get some orange. There's definitely a citrusy orange flavor in there. I expected it to be bigger, bolder, like just in your face, crushing you with orange, with blood orange. And it's not. Kind of disappointed in that, again. But it is orange. I guess it's supposed to be a pale ale, so you don't get a lot of, not a lot of hops in there. I mean, there's no bitterness at all. This is almost like an orange soda. This is like, kind of like a weaker version of Fanta almost. Now, you could drink a lot of these. You could easily drink a lot of these. Definitely is a very crushable beer. But not, it's a good beer. This is a good beer. It does have a good flavor. It is what it says it is. Blood orange pale ale. I just would have expected more from a can with Slayer all over it. That being said, I would still give it a thumbs up. I would drink another one. I have drank this before. I am drinking it again. So, if you're a fan of Slayer or heavy metal, it is a cool can to have. It's worth like the $2.50 or whatever you can find it for just to have the can. That is some pretty cool artwork. But although I don't have a bus call, it is time for me to wrap up this video of rambling long enough. If you like the video, please hit that like button. Please hit subscribe if you want to see more of my videos. If you want to see me do more of these videos, I'm just getting started out here. Also down in the comments, let me know what you think about this beer, what you think about Slayer, you want to talk about metal, whatever. Just hit me up down in the comments. And this is the Ginger Yeti. I'm signing off for the night. This one's for the road.